Hi, my name's Rebecca and I'm a nutritionist with Connolly's Red Mills. We're going to talk about Equine Gastric Ulcer Syndrome, or EGUS as it's more commonly known. We've known for some time now that equine gastric ulcers have been a problem for the horse. It varies between age, breed and use, but we do know that the highest incidence happens in the thoroughbred racehorse. Gastric ulcers can be very painful and can not only inhibit the horse's performance, but can also affect his quality of life. Clinical symptoms vary from horse to horse. Some exhibit classic poor appetite, poor performance, poor coat. Others will show no clinical symptoms whatsoever. Diagnosis is only by gastroscopy, or passing a camera down into the horse's stomach. We can't really tell from the outside looking in what's going on in their stomach. So let's look at the main causes of EGUS and what we can do to manage the problem and try and minimize the risk. The fact is, almost everything that we do with our horses, from bringing them into the stable, isolating them from their paddock mates, intermittent feeding, everything, stress, transport, competition, everything contributes to the cause of gastric ulcers. But two things in particular which we're going to look at are the intermittent feeding, not enough fiber in the diet, and also exercise. Strenuous exercise on an empty stomach has thought to increase the risk somewhat. The horse's stomach is split into two parts. There's the non-glandular part at the top and the glandular part at the bottom. The glandular part is where the stomach acid is secreted, and this is protected from the acid by a thick mucus layer. There is a line that goes around the middle between the two parts called the margo plicatus. This is also a common area or site for gastric ulcers in the horse. If the horse is exercised on an empty stomach, stomach acid can splash up from the glandular part into the non-glandular part, causing gastric ulcers. Therefore, feeding a small amount of leafy hay, such as alfalfa, small amount of fiber, or even just feed in the horse's stomach before he goes out to exercise will absorb that stomach acid and will help reduce the splashback effect. As we know, the horse is a grazing animal. He spends up to 20 hours a day in the wild, nibbling on grass and other fibers in his environment. To combat this, he's continually producing stomach acid, up to 1.5 liters an hour. So over the course of the day, that's a lot of acid. Now, their natural buffer to this is saliva. When the horse chews, he produces saliva, and that helps to neutralize the stomach acid in his belly. However, if the horse is not chewing, he's not producing saliva. That's why a constant supply of hay or fiber in the horse's diet, so he's continually nibbling, is really important to help him be producing saliva to help combat the stomach acid. Diets that are high in starch have also been found to contribute to equine gastric ulcer syndrome. Therefore, feeding a low starch diet, such as horse cure cubes or horse cure mix, can help horses that are prone to the condition. Likewise, restricting the amount of starch that you're feeding per meal, splitting larger meals into smaller meals throughout the day, can help to reduce the risk. Additional energy can be added to the diet in the form of highly digestible fibers or oils, such as Kentucky Karen oil from Forens, which will increase the energy you're supplying without increasing the starch in the diet. Because stress highly contributes to EGUS, it's a good idea to look at your management routine. Try to keep things simple and the same for the horse. Horses like routine, whether that's their feeding time, their exercise time, even their exercise rider. By keeping all these things the same, you can help to reduce the stress in his environment from a day-to-day basis. If you have access to grazing, turnout also helps. This is increasing not only the fiber in the diet, the chew time, the saliva production, but giving the horse a chance to switch off and actually be a horse for a few hours during the day. The only effective way to treat equine gastric ulcer syndrome is by medication from your veterinary surgeon. However, with management changes and dietary changes, such as a low starch diet, we can help to minimize the risk. You might also consider feeding a supplement, such as Foreign Equine NutriGuard, which can help support gastric health. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and for more of these brought to you by our nutrition team at Conley's Red Mills, please go to our website where you can ask our experts. If you found this video useful, then please like, comment, or share. Thank you for watching.